Hello everyone, this is Shiv Prem, a legal intern at Lexis & Company and currently pursuing BLLB honors from Central University of South Bihar. In this video, I will be dealing with the writ of prohibition. In the previous video, I had gone through the writ of certiorari. This is the whole part of writ of certiorari and prohibition. It is the second part where I am just going to elaborate the discuss about the writ of prohibition. Okay. So, starting with writ of prohibition. A writ of prohibition is a judicial writ and can be issued against a judicial or quasi-judicial authority that exceeds its jurisdiction or tries to exceed its jurisdiction. Prohibition literally means to forbid or to stop, and it is popularly known as a stay order. Now let us see against whom the writ of prohibition doesn't lie. It would not lie against the legislature restraining it from enacting or enforcing law. A writ of prohibition may lie only in cases where the proceedings are pending before the judicial or quasi-judicial authority. It can't be exercised when the authority has functus officio, meaning their decision taken by authority. Well, now, let us see about the grounds for the issue of prohibition. The writ of prohibition can be issued on the same ground on which the certiorari can be issued, except in the case of an error of law apparent on the face of the record. The grounds for the issue of prohibition are like lack of excess of jurisdiction, violation of principles of natural justice, infringement of fundamental rights, fraud, and contravention of the law of the land. In these five, I had gone through the, I think, two or three parts in the last video in the writ of certiorari. You may go through it if you want to have a elaborate discussion on it. So, contravention of law of the land. The prima facie meaning is that the erroneous interpretation of the law, especially a statute law which forms the bulk of law in operation, is included in the grounds for the issue of prohibition. Now let us see a case of Lakshmi Indra Titra Swamiyar versus Hindu religious endowments. In this case, it was held that the prohibition is a writ of right, hence the existence of an alternative remedy is an irrelevant consideration when the complainant is that the inferior tribunal is exceeding the jurisdiction or is assuming jurisdiction not vested by the law, because it would amount to forcing a person to first suffer and submit to the jurisdiction of the other authority, which is illegal, and then take advantage of the alternative remedy before approaching the court. So, the writ of certiorari and prohibition are of similar nature. Certiorari applied when the decision of the judicial or quasi-judicial passed and the decision given by the court are out of their judicial jurisdiction, whereas writ of prohibition applied before the judgments to ensure whether that court functions under the jurisdiction or not. Writ of certiorari may be applied by the party whose rights are violated, and when the rights of the public are violated, then any person may apply. The writ of certiorari is also known as corrective writ or the writ of error, where the writ of prohibition is popularly known as the stay order. So, we can say that although the administrative authority has wide discretionary power, they cannot exercise this power extensively. Whenever they exercise their power by abusing jurisdiction, then the court has the power to quash the order of the administrative authority. So, that's all for now. Let us meet in the next session with a different topic. Thank you, and please do like and subscribe the channel.